generation of rugby league players here in Australia will remember for an absolute lifetime. Not many rugby league players get the chance to play here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. And I guess for a lot of these junior Blues and junior Kangaroos, as they come out onto the field with the New South Wales Blues, a moment these young guys, the next generation of rugby league players here in Australia, will remember for an absolute lifetime. Not many rugby league players get the chance to play here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. And I guess for a lot of these junior Blues and junior Kangaroos, it might even be their first time that they've even ventured inside the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Yeah, I'm sure it is the first time they've come in. I haven't been here for, you know, many, many years, and I'm, you know, a lot of people haven't been here, but it's a moment that I will never forget.
Okay, Terry, well, let's go through the New South Wales squad.
Yeah, for New South Wales, it's the fullbacks Ryan Papahausen, the wingers Remus Smith and Ruben Garrick, Curtis Scott and Jesse Rahman, the centres, Brock Lamb and Jack Cogger are the halves. The prop forwards are Daniel Vasquez and Blake Laurie. Daniel Peck's the hooker. Brody Jones and Ray Stone are the second rowers. Gabe Hamblin is the lock. The interchange is Kate Cust, Brock Eilad, Billy Bengulius and Billy Bainbridge. And they're coached by Todd Payton.
Okay, let's quickly go through the Queensland side. At the fullback is Shivasaki. On the wings is Enrari Tuwala and also Bernard Lewis. The 3 and 4 is Kenan Yorston and Backshow Salem. The 6 and 7, keep your eyes on these players for Queensland, Mitchell Dunn and Joshua Fayud. The back rowers of Hipsgrave, Cotter, Dawson, Sua, Molo and Lenski. The interchange bench for the Queensland under 18 Maroons is Tristan Hope, Tonis Makili, Keenan Palacia, Cameron Torpy, and of course the 18 who may get his opportunity tonight for the Queenslanders is Brody Croft. And of course they're coached by Anthony Seibold. So we see now the kickoff has taken place and Queensland have the opportunity on the fourth tackle to come back out to the halfway line. Deep back line spread to the right-hand side. They take it inside the New South Wales territory now. And this is the Brisbane Broncos under-20s player, Jaden Sua. Big wraps on him. Comes back there now to Fayud. He goes high to the air. It comes down for Queensland, and New South Wales are over the top to bring them into the ground, led, of course, by their centre three-quarter in Jesse Rahman.
That's a positive set there for Queensland, 70 metres there on their first set.
So New South Wales coming outside their own 30-metre line here at the G as we build towards the big one at 8 o'clock tonight between New South Wales and Queensland. A moment these guys, as I mentioned at the top of the program, will not just remember for a few days or a week or a month, for a lifetime. Lifetime memories will come out of this match here tonight at the G. As the ball now beat played back to New South Wales and they take it towards the Queensland 40-metre line. This is Gabe Hamblin, helped steer the Rabbitohs from seventh spot to reach the SG Ball Grand Final this year. At the back at Shibasaki. He takes the ball well before the defence comes over the top, led, of course, there by the New South Wales crafty hooker in Daniel Peck. So defence so far so good for New South Wales, trapping the Queensland Maroons well inside their own 20-metre zone. 35-minute halves in the under-18s as Queensland. Error-free football to start their campaign of 2015 in the under-18s. There he'll cross the halfway line, taking it forward. This is Lachlan Lansky. Brisbane Broncos under-20s. Plays for Brothers also in the Bundaberg Cup. He's done so for three seasons. Pappenhausen's at the back, being knocked into the lush MCG turf there by Keenan Dawson. Welcome to the MCG.
And Queensland, again, that was a nice good set from them, another 80 metres. So they're looking good so far.
So the Blues, outside their own 20-metre zone, up towards the 30-metre line, tackling in numbers the Maroons. One of them over the top was Lenski. They come now through their second rower in Brody Jones from the Newcastle Knights. scored 7 tries for the Newcastle SG ball squad this year. He's a massive weapon in the back row for New South Wales. Look for him tonight to feature prominently. Just outside the 40 goes the kick. Sending it away from Bernard Lewis. He's currently with the Sydney Roosters, playing in the under-20s. Originally from the Cairns Kangaroos. Plays it back to Shibasaki. He now finds Keenan Yorston. Queensland born, plays with the Cronulla Sharks SG ball. Represented the Australian schoolboys last year over in the UK and France. So testing period for both of these sides as they open their encount. 5 minutes gone here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Great to have your company. As the ball now in the possession of Dawson, and Keenan will play it back. Good roll forward here. This is back to Fayud. Goes away to Papenhuyzen. He's been picked up and driven again into the ground from Michael Molo, who's the Brisbane Broncos under-20s.
Well, New South Wales, they need to watch the Queensland hooker, Ruben Cotter. He's really getting away from dummy up very quickly and making some easy yardage.
Now, this is Ruben Garrick. He's from Illawarra. Now they cross their own 40-metre line, the Blues, up towards halfway. They're about to cross the halfway line. This is Blake Laurie. He's played a bit of NYC for the Dragons this year. Has a good offload in him, as we witness there. This is Papenhuyzen. He's down to the 20. And Shibasaki comes across in cover. Here comes New South Wales. Back to Peck. They work the left-hand side. Away to Jones. He offloaded the pass. It's still on for New South Wales. But the pass has gone forward. So no try. So close, yet so far for the Blues.
And it was the fullback, Papenhuyzen. He went very close to scoring. He's already scored 15 tries this year for Balmain. He's very, very dangerous in open play.
As we have a look on the replay, that was the forward pass. Referee tonight, Jared Cole, right on the spot. He awards no try to the Blues. So the Queenslanders back outside their own 40-metre line. And this is Ruben Cotter. He plays for the Mackay Cutters. Back to Dawson. Beats one. Offloads the pass. Away to Dunn. And he's wrestled into the ground there from Cogger, the captain for New South Wales. They're going to come the commentary side. They've got an overlap out here. They're down the touchline. This is Lewis. He'll kick it for the inside. Where's the man coming through? New South Wales, they defuse the opportunity, Terry. Back out to the 20. But don't the Maroons look like they're on fire after 5 minutes of this one?
Yeah, well, all the momentum is with Queensland. Like I said earlier, they are making some easy yardage. New South Wales, they really need to, you know, stop them getting that quick play of the ball.
So the start has been impressive by both of these squads. As we see now, New South Wales inside the Queensland territory. They'll cross the 40-metre line now through their lock forward in Cabe Hamlin. As I mentioned, he helped steer the Rabbitohs from seventh spot to reach the SG Ball Grand Final in New South Wales about 4 weeks ago. The way these sides are playing, you wouldn't think there was any nerves out there. They're primed, they're prepped, and they're ready for this occasion here at the MCG. Penalty to the Blues here, Terry, 20 metres out from the Queensland goal line.
Yeah, it was the second round from Queensland, Jaden Suia, that had a hand in the ball there. Ball came loose. New South Wales now going for the try.
10 metres away. The wide shot tells you the story. As the Blues looking to come to the eastern side of the edge. Papenhuyzen, he's straight through. He'll score the first try on the MCG for State of Origin Night 2015.
A fantastic try there. And like I said, he's very dangerous open field. He's scored already 15 tries for Balmain. And I'm sure he's probably going to score, you know, a few more here if he's given the chance. Now, Queensland, they had all the momentum going there, but against the play and on the back of that penalty, it's New South Wales that opened the scoring there.
Well, Ryan Papenhuyzen from the Balmain Tigers He has scored 15 tries from fullback in the SG ball this year. He is an absolute electric runner of the ball. And as you could see there on the replay, nobody is going to stop him that close to the goal line. And he has opened the scoreboard up here on the NRL.com scoreboard by 4-0. If you ever want to kick here at the MCG, well, he's about to have the opportunity now from right in front.
And Ryan Pappenhausen, he's got to inject himself as many times as possible because he's dangerous.
Well, speaking to New South Wales Rugby League Performance Programs Manager Jamie Feeney this week, and he said Ryan is an electric runner, as we mentioned, of the football, and extremely mature at the back in defence as well. I think we can take that one step further. Extremely mature when it comes to finding the try line as well. What a moment for Ryan Pappenhausen from the Balmain Tigers. We haven't seen State of Origin here at the MCG for over 18 years. He would have only been born last time we played rugby league here at the G. So what a start for them. And you're listening to this coverage and watching our pitches tonight, live and exclusive on NRL.com. Also taking our coverage is the New South Wales Rugby League website and up through Queensland on the QRL website. Big audience already tuned into this one. Welcome to State of Origin Night, Game 2, live out of the MCG. Not a bad crowd in here as well as we count down to 8 p.m. tonight. So time off here from our referee in Jared Cole. So the clock has stopped with exactly 24 minutes and 40 seconds remaining. Just a reminder, in the 18s, we only had 35-minute halves. But a brilliant start for the Junior Blues here. Back then out of the kick, good hands, wasn't it, there from Codger. Puts in the kick downfield, swirling around. Shibasaki may have knocked on. Fingertip control has gone wrong for their dynamic fullback.
And he had plenty of time to take that ball.
Well, anybody that will play AFL here will tell you that this swirling breeze can really take you off your game. And I think what we just witnessed there, Shibasaki, he'll probably agree with that.
And the momentum has swung over now to New South Wales. You know, they're leading 6-0. Now they've got another great chance, 15 metres out from the Queensland try line.
Well, Queensland tonight, big raps coming from South Logan's pair, Jaden Sewer, and Wynnum Manley's Keegan Hipsgrave, who's the captain tonight for Queensland. They've got plenty of NYC experience, playing under-20s for the Brisbane Broncos. And look for them to go out to their wing as well. And Ari Tuwala, what a final series he had in Queensland for the Townsville Stingers. He scored a match-winning try in the Malmeninga Cup. But Queensland on the defence here as New South Wales searching for their second try of the match. This is Blake Laurie from St. George Illawarra. Comes back to Peck. They continue to come out to the edge. Big palm from Rahman. He's close to the line. Flicks out the back to Pappenhausen. They're keeping it alive, the Blues. Back to Jones. And he takes a tackle there of Dawson and the captain in Hipgrave. 5 metres out from the Queensland line. They lead by 6-0. This is Brock Lamb taken into the ground, ball and all. Still on for New South Wales. They cut out one to go to Cogger. Is this another try coming out wide? Queensland trying to scramble, but not enough. I think they've got their second of the match. They have. Try for New South Wales. Well, they had to scramble Queensland, but unfortunately they couldn't get across in cover. And New South Wales have opened the second try of the match and going to Curtis Scott from the Cronulla Sharks.
And that was a great backline movement. It was, you know, the ball was spread wide, just like, you know, the NRL. It was greatly, if you can look at the pass here, And Sky, you know, he had a lot of work to do. You know, he still had two players to get through, and he did well to get the ball over the line. And that came on the back of the penalty for the first try, and now the second try came on the back of when they lost the fullback, dropped the ball.
Just barged his way over, as you can see there on the NRL replay. Well, the family and friends have come down from New South Wales, especially from the Cronulla region, as we sit at the top of the program. Four of Cronulla's national championship winning stars have been rewarded in the New South Wales team here tonight at the G. Of course, Curtis Scott, he's the under-18s SG ball captain for the Cronulla Sharks. Very talented, young, dynamic player, and certainly showed there a lot of determination and takes the game, I guess, to that extra level. Here's the kick from right out on the touchline, Frurarik. It's coming back around from the sideline. He's nailed it. Well, they can't do anything wrong. New South Wales here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. They lead by 12 points to nil after 20 minutes of the match.
And New South Wales does have the wood on Queensland when it comes to under-18s. Since it started in 2008, there's been seven matches, and New South Wales has won six of them, and Queensland have only won one, and that was back in 2012.
So the Blues coming back outside their own 20-metre line. Just going through a few facts. 2 years ago, I believe, Queensland, probably a day to forget, Sai got beat 36-0 in the under-16s, and a lot of the Queenslanders who went around back then are taking their part here tonight at the G as well. But we know that rugby league can be a funny game. So 12 points to nil at this stage. They can certainly come back into it. Last tackle now for New South Wales. This time they'll go between the fullback and the winger. Gemet Shibasaki plays for the Townsville Stingers. Only 17 years of age. He's also already played for the Queensland under-12s, the 15s and the 16s. And you can add that now to under-18s for his impressive rugby league career so far. Mika Eli from the Ipswich Jets is on the field for the Queensland Maroons as they cross the New South Wales territory. Quick play the ball. This is what they want. Little chip over the top. The fullback is positioned deep. And now he's being collared. He flicks it back on the inside, Ryan Papenhuyzen. But the referee here, be interesting, Terry, to see which way he gives the feed. He does. He gives it to Queensland. So this is their opportunity to strike now. 10 metres out from the Blues goal line.
You would have thought that would have warranted a penalty, but he's decided to give Queensland the feed. And this is a great chance for Queensland to hit back.
Well, look out for Tuwala, as I mentioned, on the wing. Picked up that match-winning try in the Malmaninga Cup Grand Final. And he also scored a hat-trick of tries in the State Cup Final, which we telecasted live on NRL.com against the Cronulla Sharks out at Belmore. No doubt he'll be the one to watch. If the ball comes wide in this set of six, Fayud, they come out wide. This is Shibasaki. He takes a tackle there of Lamb. 2 metres out from the New South Wales goal line. Back then out at Cotter. He barges his way towards the New South Wales line. They finally put him down there from Laurie. Queensland looking to strike back here. Down by 12 points to nil. Lansky's with the ball. They finally drop him down there from Peck. 2 metres out from the Blues goal line. Cotter is with it. He goes short. The Maroons trying to bash and barge their way over. Michaeli may have done just that. He has. Queensland have scored their first try. Thomas Michaeli from the Ipswich Jets He also played for the Queenslanders in the under-16s a few years ago. He's got Queensland on the scoreboard. They trail by 12 points to 4.
Just sheer strength that Michaeli, he looked like he was tackled there. There's three players there, but he had another go and went over the try line.
There he is on screen now. Michaeli up from the Ipswich Jets. Comes from Keeper Park High School. His junior club was the Goodness Eagles. And as I mentioned, represented Queensland in the under-16s a few years ago. Big raps from Thomas Michaeli, from some good judges. And also, he'll give himself a rap after scoring the first try for Queensland here. So here's the kick now from 15 metres out, taking their time. 15 minutes to go on the NRL scoreboard first half. It's a bripper. So Queensland have been able to convert their first try. So we've got a 6-point ball game here at the G, Terry.
And at Queensland, they've just got to keep doing what they've done, especially in that first 5 minutes of the game. They're making a lot of yardage. They didn't panic. They were down 12-0. They've hit back. And now it's game on. Interesting, Peter. It's also that last year when New South Wales won in Sydney 24-10. Sione Mataudia was playing in that game. And a few months later, he was playing for Australia in the Four Nations final.
Definitely a great breeding ground, isn't it? Who knows where our future stars of rugby league here playing tonight for New South Wales and for both Queensland will end up in years to come. Of course, Mitchell Dunn has also got a contract, the 5'8", already with the Cowboys, and a lot of these back rowers have also got contracts in the under-20s for the Brisbane Broncos as the Maroons now. Looking to go up an extra gear. Back to Dunn. He gives it away to Sua. That was the changeover. Was the last tackle for Queensland. So New South Wales come away with it. 15 metres out from their own goal line. But also Townsville captain and 5'8 tonight for the Queenslanders. As I was just mentioning, Mitchell Dunn. He's actually signed only a few months ago to play for the under-20s for the North Queensland Cowboys. Dunn tonight, he'll be playing alongside his Townsville teammate in Backshow Salem. He scored his double in the State Cup final a few weeks ago. So both of these players for Queensland, along with their other 12 alongside of them, looking to get themselves back into this contest and thump the Blues. Here's the kick rolling towards the eastern touchline. And New South Wales, fine touch, 10 metres out from the Maroons' goal line.
First touch finder for the night. Now, talking about players such as Sione Mataudia, in 2013 he was in the under-18s team as well, and in the same side was Alex Johnston for South Sydney. He also went on to play for Australia. Other players playing in 2013 included Jack Bird and Valentine Holmes, now teammates at Cronulla.
Also out there in the middle, as we mentioned, our referee tonight, Jared Cole. Big night for our young referee out there in the middle. He's assisted by his sideline eyes, his touch judges in Liam Kennedy and Damian Brady. So a big night, not just for the players, but for the officials going around here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground as well. There's a nice crowd slowly building up. We're expecting a crowd in the high 80,000 as we go inside the last 2 hours before the big one. Can Queensland wrap up the series tonight? Here's a penalty, 10 metres on their own side of halfway. We haven't seen too many penalties in this under-18s, but Queensland now, with 12 minutes remaining on the clock, shoot for the western touchline. So an opportunity coming up for now for them. 38 metres out from the New South Wales goal line. The This is Jaden Sewer. Junior club, came from the Logan brothers. As I mentioned, one of four Brisbane Broncos under-20s out here this afternoon into the evening. I guess you'd call this the twilight match, the curtain raiser to the big one. But this doesn't come any bigger for these players, does it? This is Fayud out the back to Dunn. He finds Yorston. Takes four New South Wales players to bring him into the ground. He's lost the football, though, 5 metres out from the New South Wales goal line.
Yeah, great defence from the Blues there. They needed that. Queensland was, you know, they were picking up the momentum. And Yorston, it looks like he was his teammate from Cronulla that stopped him.
So a scrum will be packing down here. The northern end of the MCG. I've got to say, when you put a rugby league field in the middle of the cricket ground, it looks quite small, but we're way up in the
clouds,
pretty much. We could have had the plane above us here hovering around, but a great vantage point nonetheless, though, Terry. You see the holes opening up, don't you? One was about to open there, but the defense from the Queenslanders come through from Baksho Salem. Townsville stinger as now New South Wales go down the sideline. Cover defense coming through from Lansky, and they push him into touch. Possibly a try-saving tackle for the Queenslanders.
A great tackle. I think if he missed that tackle, it could have been away for an 80-metre try there. Queensland are looking good. They're making good yardage, and it's important that the defence from New South Wales holds out. Now, with the under-18s, like I said, it started in 2008, but before then it was the under-19s. 2007 was the last time the under-19s was played. New South Wales won that. And the last time Queensland won that was in 2005. They beat New South Wales 42-12 at Suncorp. And there was a player there that scored two tries that went by the name of Greg Inglis.
Who will be the next Greg Inglis tonight? Will it be this man, Lachlan Lansky? Could it be Cotter? Or Fayud, who's with the ball? Is it McKellieli? The pass has gone forward. It was flat. He was into a gap. But unfortunately, the man on your screen right there in Thomas McKellieli, who scored the first try for Queensland here tonight at the Melbourne Cricket Ground, couldn't quite get into open space. So the scrum now being fed. Blues into the field. 21 metres out from their own goal line. Cogger, the captain, from the Newcastle Knights, sending the ball left-hand side of the field. They continue to come up the middle of the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Heavy defence there coming through from the Maroons, led, of course, there by Molo. Now this is their big number 18 on the park. And, of course, that's Sam Elliott getting up to play the football just short of the halfway line. Back then out to Islet. Another one from the Cronulla Sharks. He's been sensational for the Sharks this season. They're going backwards here, Cronulla. They'll look to
the Blues.
The Blues in their blue and white stripe. I was going to say, very identical to Cronulla, but here's the Blues inside their own 40. Here's the kick. Charge down. Could be six more tackle. This is Papenhuyzen. And Terry, he's got the ball. So the tackle count has restarted here. 42 metres out from the Maroons line. New South Wales on the attack now through Brody Jones. As I mentioned, seven tries for Newcastle Knights this season in the SG ball. He takes it now down to the 30-metre line. That's where he's going to be met by the Maroons. So centre of the field, centre of the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Which way will they come now? They go up the middle of the park. They're away. Great ball back on the inside. I think that pass might have went forward. It's been called back. They can't get their third try, New South Wales. The pass went forward. Nearly a penalty. That's how far forward that one went.
It was 3 metres forward, but they should have just taken the tackle there. They had a lot of tackles still up their sleeve. And I think Blues will learn from that.
Well, this is it on the replay. Daniel Beck Got that pass away, but our referee out there in Jared Cole was right on the spot. Also got a call from his left touchy and Liam Kennedy. So Mitchell Dunn signed with the Cowboys, putting the ball into the scrum, giving it away to Molwo, and he takes it outside his own 20 metre line. Now this is Yorston up from the Cronulla Sharks, one of four. Now they continue to come inside the New South Wales territory. They've lost the football. I think that might have been helped. Referee agrees. A penalty to Queensland here, Terry. 40 metres out from their own goal line.
Third penalty in the game. Queensland, that's the second. And it's these kind of penalties that, you know, is going to get Queensland back in the game. They've got to stop doing these because it's just it's easy yardage for the opposition.
Well, they're inviting them back. Let's see if they can turn the penalty into a try. If they can't get that, look for the kick into the in-goal area to get a reset set back. This is Hipgrave, the captain for the Brisbane Broncos, under 20s. Back it comes to Hope. Away to Dunn. He finds Fayud. This is Shipasaki trying to beat Margulius. McKellieli back to Lansky. Islet wraps him up. Slow play the football here at the G. The Maroons work it to the great southern side into the field. Molo from the North Devils. Last tackle now for the Maroons. Back to Hipgrave, the captain. He's held up. Held up for Queensland. Great scrambling defence from New South Wales.
It was Brody Jones there that went underneath there and held him up.
Well, Keegan Hipgrave, the captain.
It's a bonus too. It was on the last tackle, so Blues get the ball.
As I mentioned, he's just signed a two-year deal, I believe, with the Brisbane Broncos. His junior club is the Nerang Roosters. He also represented Australia last year when the Australian schoolboys went overseas to France and the UK. So plenty of experience as now New South Wales great hands. Rahman down the sideline. He beat Salmon. Sliced him open, didn't he? 30 metres away from the Queensland goal line. Cogger away to Lamb. Down to the 30 metre line. They don't want to go into the ground, New South Wales. Until now, ball comes back away to Garrick. Finding Cogger from one end of the field to the other. This is Jones, quick hands. Smith, he's got butterfingers out there. Ball goes into touch.
Well, to his defense, it wasn't the best pass.
As you can see there on the replay, just looked up at the great southern stand. Said, wow, I'm here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
And the Blues look dangerous when they spread the ball wide.
Well, we know Smith and also Garrick. There's plenty of agility and speed out there on the wings for New South Wales. So reading the game plan, Terry, looks like they're just going to go up the middle both sides and then exploit the edges on the fourth or fifth tackle. So Queensland now, only 2 minutes to go in the first half, trailing by six. Here comes Queensland. Back to Dawson. He's got a good offload in him, but not on that occasion. Plays it back, 30 metres out now from the New South Wales line. Away to Dunn, great ball. But Shibasaki, he couldn't hang on to it for the Maroons. Another scrum this time. 10 metres out. Look at this on the replay.
It was touched by the Blues, so it's going to be a Queensland feed.
Well, perfect result. And as you can see there, Mitchell Dunn has ball in hand. So New South Wales, can they hang on with 2 minutes remaining in the first half? Time off here at the G. Bit of a blood bin for New South Wales. So a bit of a breather. So both sides.
The clock's still ticking down, so I don't think there's any time off here in the under-18s match.
So the clock still ticking away as New South Wales and Queensland looking to lock horns here in the middle of the scrum. As you can see there, Brody Jones coming off the field for New South Wales and going on is Billy Bainbridge. He'll trouble Queensland with his speed and strength. Now this is Mitchell Dunn putting it in, giving away to Hipgrave, the captain, taking it down to the 10-metre line. 1 minute left on the clock in the first half. Here on the NRL.com scoreboard, back to Dawson. Bainbridge takes him into the ground. Away to Hope. Fayud, he finds Dunn. Away to Sewer. That might bring a penalty. It has. Stripped out.
Do you take the two?
As we look on the replay, I don't think you do at this time of the match, Terry. I think you take the tap and try and crack them leading into the break. And Queensland, exactly, that's what they do do. 2 metres out from the New South Wales line. This is Hope. Short, flat, away to Hipgrave. He's on his back. 1 metre out from the line. Are they building here? Hope! He hopes and plays and gets the try, which puts Queensland within 2 points of New South Wales. They're back, Queensland, here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Well, the right decision not to go for goal, and everyone took Hope's dummy, and he went in for what looked like a simple try.
Well, you're about to have a look at it on the NRL replay. Just take a look at this. Tristan Hope borrowing from dummy half. He's from the Toowoomba Clydesdales, Harristown School. He's no stranger to representative football for Queensland. He's represented Queensland in the under-13s, 15s, 16s, and now 18s. And the crowd, if this is anything to go by, Queensland are going to have the majority of support for the big one later tonight. The man on screen right now, Tristan Hope. What a moment for him. Scoring towards the northern end, towards Bay 13, the famous bay here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground in the cricket season. So the siren, the famous AFL hooter. Well, that's gone in the background. So here's the kick as we take you right into the kick. The Steedon football on the kicking tee. Our camera from the northwestern corner looking up at the Queenslanders as they're looking to level the scoreboard up going into half time. They do exactly just that here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. It was all New South Wales. It was all New South Wales. But in the space of the last 15, 20 minutes, Queensland have got us leveled up here, Terry, at 12 all on the NRL.com scoreboard.
Well, yeah, New South Wales, they ran out to 12-0 after 13 minutes, but in the last 15 minutes, it's all been Queensland, really, and that try will really lift them, and I think they've looked better. They should have been probably leading by a try at Queensland, but it's all square here at the MCG, 12-all. It's going to be a very interesting second half.
It will. So both sides go back now to the dressing sheds, the famous AFL dressing sheds here at the MCG, and they'll get their instructions from both of their coaches. Of course, New South Wales coach Todd Payton. Of course, Todd's got plenty of NRL experience. We're back here for the second 35 minutes Who will it be here in the under-18s between New South Wales and Queensland? Stay with us. This will be an enthralling battle right down to the 35th minute. If we're locked up at the end of full time, the game will be played a draw. There's no extra time in this one as the first knock on of the second half coming up for New South Wales here. So Queensland, they stormed home, didn't they, in the back end of the first half. Are they about once again to dominate the early moments of the second 35 minutes?
Not a good start for New South Wales there, dropping the ball and giving Queensland good field position 40 metres out from the Blues line.
So Queensland, the ball comes in. It goes out this time to Dunn. He gives it away to Shibasaki and Ruben Garrick from Illawarra. Brings him into the turf. Down to the 30-metre line. As you can see, just short. Back through the middle. This is Dunn. If you just tuned at the coverage, he's just signed a contract with the North Queensland Cowboys. This is Dawson. Billy Margulius from the Cronulla Sharks. And the SG ball takes him into the ground for the Blues. So is the pendulum about to swing early on in the second half for Queensland? Last tackle now for the Maroons. We've got space out to the edge, but Shibasaki, he puts it down. Changeover back for New South Wales, 10 metres out from the Blues goal line.
It was Chris Scott there that ran out there, put a lot of pressure on the Queensland player, and they came up with a mistake.
Now this is Curtis Scott. Well, they've had a lot of touches, haven't they? The Cronulla Sharks players were both representing the Blues and Maroons tonight. Four Cronulla National Championship players in the New South Wales squad for the under-18s. They go inside the 40-metre line, look for the kick. Away to Bainbridge. Now it's the last tackle outside their own 40. Cogger, the captain from the Newcastle Knights, bangs it downfield to Gamet Shibasaki. He's been busy, hasn't he, in defence and in attack. Penalty coming up to the Maroons. 21 metres out from their own goal line. So a relieving penalty here for Queensland. They want to play it at every opportunity upside New South Wales territory. And the line finder is a good one.
And that was on the back of a good kick there from New South Wales. It went out the window by giving away the penalty.
So the tap taken, and Queensland right in the middle of the summer's cricket pitch here. Here at the G, the most iconic sports stadium, one might say, in the world of sport, playing host to the under-18s here tonight. 31 metres out now from the New South Wales line. Queensland goes short. Luckily, Cogger was there for New South Wales. The ball spills out. Scrum time here, Terry. 18 away from the Blues goal line.
Yeah, good tackle there from the halfback, Jack Cogger. He got him. He got around the bigger player. He never really had control of the ball, and came away with the lost ball. And now New South Wales back on the attack.
Well, the 5-8 halfback combination for New South Wales tonight has been outstanding at club level for the Newcastle Knights. Of course, Brock Lamb and Jake Cogger representing Newcastle tonight. Now, there's a lot of people back up through Newcastle and the Hunter Valley and up through the Coalfields that are glued to the NRL side tonight, hoping that he can do something. This is Smith. He's going to be pushed into touch. Well, they had the right idea, but Remus Smith, as you see right here, has just been pushed and banged over the sideline.
I don't think he had any room to move at all. I think he stepped into the, on the touchline before he got pushed.
Speaking of Brock Lamb, he was just on your screen there. Exceptional kicking game and organisational skills. I know there's big raps from Matt Lantry, who's the Newcastle Knights New South Wales Cup coach up in Newcastle. So Brock Lamb developing well, along with his partner in Cogger, out of Newcastle, back to Dunn. He takes them inside New South Wales territory before he's cleaned up there from Billy Bainbridge, who plays for the Manly Sea Eagles. Now to Hope, giving it away to their captain in Hipgrave. Strong run, determined run by the captain. 20 metres out from the New South Wales line, Fayud goes short to Molo, wrapped up there by Mark Goulias. Queensland on the attack. New South Wales back on their own goal line. Hope giving it away to Dunn. Shibasaki, he goes without it as we look at on the replay for NRL.com. That's why we're going to have a scrum here to New South Wales, Terry. 10 metres out from the Blues goal line.
They're looking dangerous, Queensland. It's still 2-4. New South Wales, that don't need to panic. Plenty of time to go here. Just talking about some old plays before they've gone on to play at the highest level. And, you know, we've got Aaron Woods, Josh Dugan, Josh McGuire. They're going to be playing here in a little while, and they were all playing in the under-18s game in 2008 and 9.
As this game has been built, the future stars of rugby league on display right here. Moments like these, the guys in the maroon, all the blue jerseys, will cherish forever. Not just when they finish their rugby league careers, but right throughout their entire life. How many opportunities do rugby league players get to play on an iconic venue like the Melbourne Cricket Ground? Not too many. This is Islet, away to Peck. Lamb giving it away to Curtis Scott. And Keenan Yorston wraps him up. Back to Cogger. Off the boot of Lamb. Where's Shibasaki? Takes the whirl in his own possession. 21 metres out from his own goal line before he's wrapped up there by Smith. They pass their own 20 metre line. This is Tuwala. He's been quiet for Queensland tonight. Picked up 3 tries in the state final. And also scored that match-winning try in the Malmeninga Cup. Halfway line. Hope picked up a try. The first try tonight for Queensland. Bainbridge over the top for New South Wales. Now to Hope. Back inside the Blues territory. They're still going. Queensland bashing and barging their way down to the 10-metre line. Changeover back to New South Wales. 10 metres out from their own goal line.
It was lucky that Ray Stone was there to make that tackle. The gap looked like was going to open up there for Queensland, but Stone on the spot there to bring him down on the last tackle.
So we've got 25 minutes remaining in the second half. We've just been given the crowd figure as of 6:45. We've got a crowd in excess of 30,000 people in here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground watching these under-18s do battle here tonight. 12-all is the score. New South Wales looking to go through the gap. This is Brock Islet. He's been sensational for the Sharks this season. Tell you what, plenty of touches have come from Sharks players. in this contest. This is Lamb giving it back this time to Cogger, and the captain bangs it in between the fullback and the winger. Shibarski, he's in his in goal area. He's got a bit of room to do. He's got a bit of work to do as well.
That was a good kick. Great kick there. Perfectly placed by Cogger.
Well, this is in on the replay, Terry. Kick. I'll tell you what, check that out. From Sewer. But the penalty didn't come. Wasn't warranted. As Queensland now bring it back outside their own 30-metre line. We're live. We're exclusive, and we're coming out of the Melbourne Cricket Ground tonight. Defence from that. Led, of course, by Ray Stone from Western Suburbs. Molo, he takes it forward to the halfway line. Last tackle now for Queensland. Ball dribbling back to the 10-metre line. This is Smith with the football, giving it away with a big palm out towards his own 20-metre line. He can't get rid of Yorston. And they come back and tackle him into the ground. Led, of course, over the top by Sewer. Back to the 30-metre mark they come now, the Blues. If you want to get in contact with us, Twitter is the way to do that. Hashtag NRL. Hashtag New South Wales Rugby League, or hashtag Queensland Maroons. This is Peck giving it away to Jones. He finds Curtis Scott. Mitchell Dunn wraps him up from the Townsville Stingers. The Blues in the middle of the MCG, rampaging their way down to the 10-metre line of the Maroons. This is Ray Stone. Played schoolboys last year in France and in England. Back to Lamb, he's going to kick it. But Shibasaki, he's back there to save the day for Queensland. And Billy Bainbridge puts him on his back on his own 20-metre line. Now to Tuala. We said he's had a quiet game. Sometimes you've got to watch out for the quiet ones in the last 20 minutes. You could just spring up like Jack in the Box. Now to Hope. Solid tackle there from Brock Lamb. Along there with Billy Margulies. On the halfway line, Queensland. Solid run coming up here from Molo. Runs into Blake Laurie. 38 metres out, last tackle now for Queensland. Comes back to Hope. Little kick, little faint kick. Not sure who was that intended for, but Garrick is going to be wrestled into the ground there from Shibasaki. 20 metres out from his own goal line. Back there now to Pappenhausen. 15 tries from fullback for the Balmain Tigers in the SG ball this year. Yorston's up quickly on Curtis Scott. Well, they're keeping it alive, New South Wales. To the halfway line they come, the Blues. The Maroons in numbers. Torpy gets off him. They'll play the football back now. That's the fourth tackle. They'll come the short side. Away to Bainbridge. Salem over the top brings the Blue into the ground. Back to Peck. Vasquez, the hard-hitting prop, running strongly there, wasn't he? Here's the kick off the boot of New South Wales. Shibasaki's gone without it. It could be play on. It could be the first try of the second half for New South Wales. Referee points to the spot in Jared Cole. So the Blues extend their lead by four. They lead 16 points to 12 over Queensland.
And it was the first time in the half that they actually went up for the bomb. All the kicks had been along the ground. And it was about time that they actually put the bomb up and put a bit of pressure on the fullback, and they did. And it was the winger Smith that came away with a four-pointer.
Well, let's just have a look on the replay. Be interesting to see if this came off a New South Wales hand or the back.
No. It looks like it's from the Queensland fullback, Shibasaki.
The Junior Blues take control once more in this match. As you can see there on screen, Smith, the try scorer, comes from the Canterbury Bankstown Bulldogs. And as you could just see there, before we came back to this live shot, he possesses all the skills that make him a quality winger. And so far the crowd in here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground gone a little bit quiet. A lot of maroon support here tonight. Here's the kick now, Terry, from 12 metres out. Can they turn four into six? Yes, they can. So New South Wales convert the try. They lead by 18 points to 12 as we have a look at the front-on shot here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. This is the try to their winger, Henry Smith.
I think they should put the bomb up as many times as possible here because it's anyone's guess once the ball goes up in the air.
The crafty hookers with a Daniel Peck. The Balmain Tigers. And hasn't he kept the defenders guessing tonight? He also reads the play well. Very nuggeting type of dummy half. Just like this man, the New South Wales speed machine. And Jesse Rahman, he's a weapon in attack on the edge. Back to Vasquez. Runs hard. And he's still going, the big prop from Cronulla. Back it comes from Peck. Away to Lamb. Continuing to work the edge. This is Smith. Wrestled into the ground from Yorston. Right on the halfway line here at the G. Rahman. Well, there's a lost ball here from the Blues. Right on the halfway line.
And on the last tackle as well.
This is it here on the replay. Just keep an eye on the incident. Vasquez with the ball. Was trying to get to his feet, wasn't he? Changeover back to the Queenslanders. As I mentioned, the Queenslanders. They've been in Melbourne since last Thursday in camp. For their coach, Anthony Seibold. He said throughout the week, there's no excuses for the Queenslanders here, looking to strike their way back into the contest. 17 minutes to go in the match. Molo. Vasquez. In defense. Cotter. Away to hit Grave. And the captain will play it back. 10 metres away from the New South Wales line. This is Fayud. He drops the ball with the line wide open, cleaned up from New South Wales in their own in-goal area. This is it on the replay. Well, he actually put it on the boot in the end, and Papenhuyzen cleaned up in goal. So we're going to have a goal line drop out here. More pressure coming up for New South Wales.
Well, Papenhuyzen did very well to pick that ball up. If Queensland's zone to change player, Cameron Torby, he's been taken off. Some kind of injury, they're just assessing him now.
So here's the goal line dropout. It's a good one. Goes 50 metres on the fly for New South Wales. And Lachlan Lansky from the Brisbane Broncos in the under-20s. Junior club was with Bundaberg as well. Palacia, he's up from the Wynnum Seagulls. He'll get a penalty for his efforts here, Terry. 20 metres out from the New South Wales goal line, holding down in the tackle for too long, the Blues.
And Queensland, that's the fifth penalty in the game, two New South Wales, one.
Optimum time now for Queensland. Down by six. Can they get back into the match? This is Sewer. He's over the line. Can he get it down? Yes, he can. Jaden Sewer, the under-20s from the Brisbane Broncos, has scored 15 metres to the left-hand side of the post. Nobody was going to stop Jaden Sewer from that close to the range as we have a look on the replay.
Just too much power there. Look, two, three players there, and it does well to spin over tackle and plant the ball over the line.
Well, he's also from Logan Brothers. He's picked up numerous tries this season in the Malmeninga Cup. But maybe, just maybe, Terry hasn't scored a more important one in 2015 than that. It's given his side the chance to be down by just two with a kick to come. And listen to the crowd. The crowd went up as one as he was able to bash his barge his way over the line. Here's the kick now. 18 metres out. 10 metres off left-hand side of the post. An important kick for Queensland. Oh, it's hit the post! Will that be costly in the end for Queensland?
And it was a simple kick too, that he should have put the ball over the crossbar there.
So back to the halfway line. With Peter Jolly and Terry Liberopoulos. Live exclusive tonight out of the Melbourne Cricket Ground. What a stadium it's been over the years, of course, hosting the Cricket World Cup final earlier this year for the Australian cricket team to come away with the trophy. And of course, grand finals here at the in the AFL as well. We don't see much rugby league, do we, on this famous, iconic ground. But we have a blockbuster right here on NRL.com. Queensland, they'll kick it towards the sideline. Pappenhausen goes away and fields the ball. He better watch out for the sideline. Only a metre out from going across it as well. This is Rahman. For the Manly Sea Eagles. New South Wales speed machine, as I said, very sharp on the edge for the Blues. Now they come through the middle of the park. Laurie, back to Peck. Away to Bainbridge. Back to Peck. New South Wales leading by 18 points to 16 here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Will their two-point margin be enough to take victory? The ball awkward for Queensland. Pappenhausen, he's lost the ball. Queensland will come away with it here as we go to the replay. Check out this from Pappenhausen.
He's had an air swing.
Well, Lewis was over the top in defence from Queensland.
But once again, it was the bomb that, that caused problems for Queensland. They was lucky that in the end that that New South Wales were able to, they had an air swing there with their fullback. But New South Wales gets close again, they should go for the bomb.
This is Michael Molo, another one from the Brisbane Broncos. From the under-20s, from Logan Brothers, away to Cotter. This time it's Mitchell Dunn. Junior club was with the brothers. Went to St. Pat's College in Mackay. Signed a contract with the Cowboys. This is him again with the football. Can he spark something for the Maroons? Not on that occasion. As the little kids from Victoria look on here, trying, willing their fans, their Queensland is over the line. Fahey might have done just that. Fahey to score for Queensland. And Queensland go back to the front. 20 points to 18. Joshua Fahey from the North Devils. Under 16s a few years ago. He was grilled up by those little fellas on the sideline. And maybe between those little fellas and himself, he was able to score that try, which has put Queensland to the front by 2 points.
So again, the hooker, Reuben Cotter, that was able to keep the ball alive, get the pass away to the halfback, and who was able to score next to the post and put Queensland in front for the first time in the game.
Joshua Fayud from the North Devils. Wavell High School as well in Brisbane. Plenty of rugby league representative recommendations as well coming from the big names in rugby league. Represented the state in the under-12s a few years ago, in the under-16s, and now tonight at the iconic Melbourne Cricket Ground, 20 points to 18 with 9 minutes to go. The kick 15 meters out, 5 to the right hand side of the goalposts. An important kick to get the margin back to 4 in favour of Queensland. There's the conversion. The goal is successful and the crowd absolutely loving what they're seeing from Queensland here. A 4-point ball game here at the MCG.
It's taken them 60 minutes to hit the front. And I think, you know, Queensland are going to finish strongly.
So the kick, Terry, goes down to the goal line of Fayu, the try scorer. And this is Michael Molo being pushed back towards his own 10-metre line here at the G. The pitch is coming out of Australia's most sporting iconic venue, if not the world here tonight. Rugby league has not been played at this arena for close to 18-odd years. And everybody up in Queensland right now glued to the NRL.com stream, wishing and hoping that their boys can hang on. Not so much the case in New South Wales. As the Blues come away with a football, they'll be hoping that this penalty will help them, Terry, to get back inside the Queensland territory.
Now, it's only the second penalty of the game too. It's 5-2 to Queensland. Now, going back to MCG, you know I love my stats. Did Melbourne Storm play here at all, or they were playing at Etihad?
Yeah, they played at Etihad.
So it is, it's been 18 years.
Statsman Terry Liberopoulos, of course, the editor of Rugby League Review in the New South Wales Rugby League News, in our MCG commentary box tonight. We've only got 7 minutes remaining here at the G. New South Wales looking desperately to bounce back here. Have they got it in them? This is Laurie. High shot coming through from Queensland. This will bring a penalty. Penalty to the Blues, 30 metres out from the Queensland goal line.
Very important penalty here. The Blues, now they're going to get to about 10 metres out. They're just going to take the quick tap.
So New South Wales now have the opportunity to level the scoreboard if they can cross the line here. If converted, will it go a long way to securing victory for them? They've got to cross the line stripe first. This is Cogger, away to Lamb, losing the ball. Losing it, the Newcastle Knight. The New South Wales captain, 20 metres away from the Queensland goal line.
This is what happens when you're playing catch-up football. Bit of pressure on you.
Well, as you can see there on the replay, he looked to go away and clean it up. Unfortunately, Jared Cole got the better of him and blew his whistle to signify the lost ball. So 5 minutes to go here at the G. Joshua Fayud, the last try scorer for the Maroons. What a night he has had. As Queensland, centre of the field, centre of the cricket ground, just past their own 30-metre line here at the G. 5 minutes to go in a nail-biter. It's been a game of seesawing lengths. The Queensland charging their way down inside the Blues territory once more. Molo is with it from the North Devils, 30 metres out from the New South Wales line. Fayud, he'll kick it towards the sideline and fine touch. 10 metres out from the New South Wales goal line.
Smart kick here. They can just take the time. As you know, there's no time off for injury.
Well, that just shows all his class. Joshua Fayud kicking it into touch. As you mentioned, Terry, we don't turn the clock off here in the under-18s. So a great tactic there from the halfback from Queensland. So New South Wales, it's all in front of them, isn't it? Coming off their own 10-metre line, this is Rahman. The quickest out there for New South Wales. They'll need to give the ball to him. If that stat is pivotal, this is Curtis Scott trying desperately to come outside his own 30-metre line here. Away to Lamb. Up towards their 40-metre line, the Blues. As you can see it there, Laurie from the St. George Illawarra squad playing the football back. Away comes the Peck. Great ball back on the inside. Mitchell Dunn was there from Queensland. Now to Cogger. Inside the Queensland territory. Now they've gone back inside their own half. New South Wales going back to go forward. This is Curtis Scott.
Last tackle.
McAuley wraps him up. Last tackle now for the Blues. Lamb goes high to the air. Shamasaki's dropped the football. Picked up by Ray Stone. New South Wales, 3 minutes to go in the match. Cogger from Newcastle. A meter out. New South Wales on the attack. Vasquez. He's a meter out from the line. Queensland, they don't know what happened right there. Rahman, he's got the football. He bashes and barges his way over the top of Fayud. A meter out from the Queensland line. The Blues with the football. 4-point ball game. Great ball back to Hamlin. Hipgrave puts his body on the line for Queensland. The Blues, it's still on for them. They've slipped over. This is Lamb. He gets back up. He reaches out. It's a double movement. It was so close, yet so far from New South Wales. Well, the referee was right on the spot. We're up in the bleachers. And that was double movement, as you're about to see right here on the NRL.com replay.
It was definitely tagged. He was definitely had his hands on the ground. Correct penalty.
Queensland, have they dodged the bullet that will see them go through to full time? 1 minute 40 remaining. What a match. What a curtain raiser here at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. The Queenslanders, error-free football they'll be hoping for in this set of six. New South Wales, they need to force the error, and force the error quick. They need to do.
Just take it up for five tackles, kick it over the sideline, and that'll be enough for Queensland to win.
Exactly 1 minute ago here in the curtain raiser. Brutal defense here from New South Wales. It's hurt the Queenslander here as we go and have a look at the replay. Big tackle up around the chest bone. Hasn't brought a penalty, but what this has done, it's allowed the clock to continue. There's no time off here. Now, if you ever want to change the laws of the game, that's the perfect example, maybe in a final, to do it. As now Queensland, through Dawson, back slammed in here to the G from Ray Stone. Only 15 seconds to go. Shibasaki, he takes Queensland to the halfway line. 6 seconds to go. Queensland, they'll kick it in the touch on the floor. fans that will live with them forever.
Queensland specialised last few minutes when New South Wales had the ball. It was good defence. Alright, pulled them out. And in the end, they've got the only the second win since the under-18s started in 2008.
The man of the match for Queensland goes to their halfback in Joshua Fayu. He scored that last try, Terry, to put Queensland to the front for the